Angeles Rams and the Washington Redskins at the home of the Redskins, RFK Stadium. 38 degrees, the temperature mostly cloudy, the forecast. Should be a good day to play. Good afternoon. I'm Pat Summerall. With me, of course, as usual, analyst, former Oakland Raider, championship coach John Madden. And John, I think if you talk about today's game, Eric Dickerson perhaps said it best when he talked about the Ram philosophy last week. He said we were too finesseful. I'm not sure that's a word, but I think I know what he means.
Well, of course, and that's the thing that John Robinson said, we have to get out of that. You know, after the 49er game, John Robinson got very upset, and he said, this isn't Ram football. Maybe it's because of our new quarterback, Jim Everett. Maybe we're trying to do too many fancy things. He said, we have to go back to the physical things. They did that. They hadn't been practicing in pads. Last week, they practiced Tuesday and Wednesday in pads, said they had their two best practices of the year, the most physical practices of the year, and they have to carry that over to today.
And you know, as we talked to Joe Gibbs, the Redskin coach, it sounded like Robinson repeating himself. He had much the same feelings about the Redskins' effort over the recent weeks.
Well, the thing about John Robinson is his started after the 49er game. Joe Gibbs has started at halftime last week's game against the Eagles. He said he was so upset after that first half. He said he walked in the locker room and he was trying to draw a play in the board, and he said he couldn't draw. His hand was shaking. So he said, the heck with it. He threw the chalk down. He said he just started yelling. He didn't know what he was saying. Almost hyperventilated. He said, let's just get out there and play football. He said they also haven't been playing that physical game that they have to play. So what we have here is we have two teams that are coming in bad. They have mad coaches. They both feel that they have to be physical, and I think we're going to have a real battle out there.
We're going to get a look at the Rams on offense first, as Steve Cox will kick off for the Redskins. Back deep for the Rams, Mickey Sutton and Charles White. The series, the Skins have won four straight. They won the last meeting 51-7 right here in the playoffs in 1983. Cox set to go. Stadium sold out for the 158th consecutive time. It is going to be Charles White at the 2-yard line. White out of the pack with room. Hit down at about the 26. Todd Bowles on the stop. That's Jim Everett, the Ram quarterback. 6'5 and 212. And here's the defense he'll be facing. Four-man in front. Mann and Manley, the ends, Butts and Grant, the two tackles. Back of them, the linebackers. Daniels, Olkowitz in the middle, and Rich Malott on the other side. And in the secondary, Green and Morris in the corners, Alvin Walton and Curtis Jordan. Two hitters. Terry Orr shaken up on the kickoff. He's number 87. And the Redskins throughout the year have had problems at that position.
Well, Terry Orr, of course, had been starting in Clint Didier's place when Didier broke his hand.
And it looks like Orr might have a problem with his hand. Young Jim Everett. And John Robinson, the Ram coach, says, hey, we've got something here with this guy. Dickerson and Redden, the two runners. House is the move man. Redden on first down, maybe a yard. Charles Mann, the first man to hit him. The offense. Everett, the quarterback. Dickerson and Redden, the runners. Kevin House and Henry Eller, the wide receivers. Up front, Panky Newberry, Doug Smith, Dennis Hara, Jackie Slater, and David Hill, the tight end, second and nine. Pro Bowlers in that offensive line. House, wide left. Ellard, wide right. Dickerson, deep. Eric Dickerson hammers out close to a first down. A gain of 80, might be a little bit short. Monty Coleman brought him down.
Well, that's the first of his carries right there. The Rams were saying yesterday that they would like to run Dickerson about 30 times. And they'd like to run Barry Redden about 15 more times. That's a whole lot of running, 45.
But that's when they're there most effective.
I think, you know, to do that, as we said earlier, though, they have to get ahead.
Third and one. Dickerson gets the one and more. A gain of three. He's out to the 40. Todd Bowles made the stop. Terry Orr heading for x-rays in the Redskin locker room. It seemed to be a problem with his hand. First down Rams. They're at their own 40. Opening minutes, opening drive. Wild card playoff game between these two. Flank to the left, and now he moves in motion. Everett quickly, Redden chased and covered by a linebacker, but not very effectively, as Curtis Jordan finally knocked him out of bounds after a gain of 19.
That was Okowitz trying to get out there to get to him. Here's what Everett was getting from the backside. We see Manley getting by Pankey there. Pankey grabbing him. He just gave Everett a little tap at the end. He's going to help pick him up so the official doesn't throw one of those flags on him.
Looks like he got Jim Everett for Christmas. Handled him like a rag doll.
But Everett got the first down.
And the Rams are in Redskin territory. First and 10 at the Redskin 40. Dickerson. Fumble. The Redskins come out of the pack with it. That's Alvin Walton. Still with it. And quickly back into Ram territory. Him up, but the Redskins get that first turnover.
They were knocking the ball around there. They were going pretty good blocking here. Dickerson has the cutback, but he hit his own guy. He hit his left guard. It was Tom Newberry. It looked like his left arm hit Newberry, and the ball just hopped out of there. It wasn't a Redskin defender.
Split wide to the left, and Art Monk out to the right. We'll send the rest of the Redskin offense in just a second. Schrader is the quarterback. Rogers gets the carry, and Rogers hammers. Rogers going. And he gets down inside the 30. Leroy Irvin finally tripped him up after a gain of 15.
I'll tell you, he's going to get a great block here from Donnie Warren. Watch 85 coming across in motion. Watch that trap right there. He knocked it down. He gave the big hole in there. The guy he blocked was a nose tackle, Sean Miller. But that was a block. I mean, ooh. Donnie Warren came across there and delivered a load on Miller.
And Sean Miller never saw him coming. You're right, John. What a tremendous block. Here comes Donnie Warren in motion. Fumble. Schrader on the exchange from his offensive center, Bostic. Down it right there. Boy, things happening in a hurry.
See what happens here? It's just as he was pulling it out, it looked like he just pulled it out and just brought it right back beyond him. I'll tell you, you know, they always talk about intensity in playoffs, and whatever that word is, the level's up about three notches.
We've got it here. Second and 12. Didier is the man on the move. It to Didier. A gain of about five. It will still leave third and long as Mel Owens was there. That's one of the things that John Robinson was saying to us yesterday. Give him those short passes, but don't let him get turned upfield with it.
Well, he doesn't think that Jay Schrader can sit back there all day and look at those deep zones that they're going to play and keep his patience and throughout the whole game continue to hit the short guy.
It'll be third and eight. Sanders wide left. Kelvin Bryant in the game in place of Rogers. That's Monk moving. Schrader across the middle of Monk. Monk will get a Redskin first down out of bounds at about the 15. Leroy Irvin finally got him out of bounds.
Well, we ought to have the telephone to John Robinson on that one. He said yesterday, said, if you have a phone to me, I can tell you if we're doing well. He said, when we play our zones, he said, if they catch a ball at 5 yards and we tackle them at five, then we're playing well. He said, if they catch it at five and run another five for first downs, as we're seeing Art Monk do, we're not playing well.
And he said, we're in trouble if that happens. And right now, it would appear they are in trouble. Redskin first down. They're at the Rams 16. No score yet. Schrader. A lot of time. It's going to be out of the end zone and no one there except our sign.
And Jerry Gray chasing it. The Rams cornerback. Hey, you talked about the players that the Rams have in the Pro Bowl on offense, but they also have their two corners. This guy, Jerry Gray here, and the other corner, Leroy Irvin. And I'll tell you, that's a different thing. When you get two cornerbacks that play all zone defense, that's an amazing thing. There's all the Rams that are in the Pro Bowl, but usually the cornerbacks that make the Pro Bowl are usually man-to-man cover guys.
In this case, they're zone covers, but an aggressive zone bunch. Schrader back at his own 25, down the middle of the mark. Ball is loose. They're going to say it was down. I'm sure Jerry Gray in the middle of that pack. Donnie Warren came up with it. Gain of 7.
The old Donnie Warren there, he's a tight end who doesn't get the ball much, has to recover fumbles and stuff, but he sure made a block that started this thing off. Here's what happens here at the end of the play. You see Monk has the ball. The Rams are trying to get it out. It goes out just as he goes down, and it's rolling around here. I think the whistle blew then.
That was Mark Giroux, who was bringing Monk down. It's 3rd and 3, and Rodgers back, and they give to Rodgers. He is hit, and that'll be short of the first down by a couple of yards. Nolan Cromwell came up to make the stop after a gain of 1 with the help from Mel Owens. And Jess Atkinson comes on. Kicked 3 extra points last week against the Eagles. But he hasn't kicked a field goal in a long, long time. How about a year and a half, almost?
Against these Redskins.
Right.
He was saying last week he kicked 3 extra points. The guys were patting him on the back and stuff. He said, don't pat me for those. Wait until I get a field goal. Well,
this
here it is.
From 25 with Schrader holding. Very confident, and look at John Robinson congratulating the defensive unit. 8:59 left first quarter. Washington 3-0. Knees version of the wild card game, and the Redskins have broken on top. They lead 3-0. Steve Cox lining up and placing it down to kick it off to Mickey Sutton and Charles White if he hits it. However, as strong as he is, if he hits it, it'll be in the stands back there. Got a great leg. Didn't hit it. Out of bounds, and they'll redo the whole thing.
It looked like he shanked it, didn't it? It looked like one of those things there. You know, you're talking about a shank. I'll tell you, on that field goal of Jess Atkinson, Jay Schrader made a good play of getting that ball up. Because watch this again. The snap is low. And he puts it down. You see, it hits the ground before he picks it up on the short hop, gets the laces turned around, and the perfect hole for Atkinson. That was a heck of a play by Schrader.
Short hop?
Well, that's what you get from your baseball days.
Right.
Of course, before Jay Schrader played with the Redskins, he played 3 years of professional baseball.
Steve Cox now will tee it up back at the 30, and the Ram receivers, Sutton and White, move up. George Rogers, who had that big 15-yard run already and gained over 1,000 yards this year, having his thumb taped up.
You always go into those stats. If this guy gains over 100 yards,
yeah,
you always win or whatever. It's true of both of these running backs.
Rogers and Dickerson. Good high kick by Cox. Fielded at the 6 by Charles White. Over one man, gets just outside the 20. Todd Bowles again as the first man down with a lot of help from a lot of friends.
Well, he had Dean Hamill down there. The Redskins are one of the few guys, CM number 78, to use a big 200. 280-pound guy running down. But watch him break the wedge. Watch here. He's a wedge buster. He just puts the wedge back going the other way. Then that lets other guys get in there.
He hit Mike McDonald and knocked him back toward the end zone very quickly.
I'll tell you, you know what his nickname is? Tasmanian Devil. When you have a Tasmanian Devil running down on a kickoff, you got something.
A lot of things happen as Barry Redden whirls over the left side for a gain of four. Stopped by safety man Curtis Jordan and Rich Mallott. Redden, as John Madden said earlier, Redden is expected by the Rams to carry the ball 15 times. Dickerson, 30 at least. Second and six it'll be. Dickerson. Face mask, penalty marker, Dickerson by man.
Yeah, that's one play that the Rams have in special for this game. They're going to key the defensive end, which would be man in that case. If he works out or up the field, Dickerson's going to cut back in. If he stays tight, they'll go out.
Here's your foul, face mask, number 71 on the defense. 15-yard penalty, first down.
This is a 15-yard penalty. This is the industrial version of this penalty. See, now, when he sees man outside, he's going to cut back inside. Now, man grabs a face mask there. And I guess he must have twisted or did some other things down below, because they have two varieties, the 5 and the 15, and that was the 15. I'm not sure why.
Industrial. I like that. Gordon McCarter's the referee, by the way. That's Redden hit right at the line of scrimmage. No gain for that one. Rams owner, Georgia Frontieri, owner and president of the Los Angeles Rams. She's just trying to stay warm, not block out the crowd noise. Second down and 10, and time for us to have another good look at rookie quarterback Jim Everett. 6'5". He can see over a lot of folks. He can also overthrow some folks.
Well, I think he had to on that one, Pat. The middle linebacker, Neil Okowitz, number 52, was on a blitz, and no one picked him up. Watch him right here, right in the middle of the screen. See 52, he comes on a delayed blitz. Now, no one picks him up, and right there, Everett sees that, knows that he either has to take the sack or get rid of the ball.
Third and 10, Redden moves to the sideline. They'll go with three wide receivers down. Ron Brown didn't know if he was going to play or not, but he's the third. Split wide to the right. Great speed. Redskins with a blitz again. Everett. Intended for Henry Ellard. And now a flag goes down. Way back, late.
I'll tell you, it was Jackie Slater and Charles Mann. Right there to Slater, the all-pro, blocking against Mann. The play was over, and they kept going.
Again, Gordon McCarter is the referee. He's the one in the black hat.
I hope this isn't one of those against both guys so nothing happens.
It very well could be, though.
Well, he's explaining it to Curtis Jordan first. Oh, they call it against Slater.
John Robinson doesn't necessarily agree.
Foul, unnecessary roughness, number 78 on the offensive team. The foul occurred after the incompletion. The down counts, fourth down.
Slater was just out there, just an offensive tackle, just out there working, and he just kept blocking against Charles Mann. And threw a flag, says you can't do that, you got to stop.
I thought for a moment he'd been thrown out of the game, but he hasn't. Eric Yarber is number 80. Hatcher back to punt. Yarber standing at the Redskin 35 as the Rams take a long time. 7:13 left to play first quarter. Redskins leading 3-0. And they let the time run down on the 32nd clock. And they'll move them back five. I'm not sure why, unless they were not sure about their offensive or punting alignment.
Relay of game, offense, still fourth down.
Well, that's something that there's sure no way that they'd want to do that. And, you know, they had one guy split out on the right, the other end tight on the left, and it looked like they were trying to audibleize to get maybe two guys in tight. We'll see, because that's the way they're starting now. That's what it was. They were trying to get their other end to come in, and they wanted a tight punt formation like they have now. See all the guys there. They couldn't get it, so they just took too much time.
Redskin pressure, but the kick is a good one. Yarber. And it takes a ram, bounce, goes out of bounds, and the Redskins will take over at about their own 40-yard line. A 41-yard punt, no return. Redskins lead 3-0, 7:03 left first quarter. Washington 3-0, Jay Schrader, the Redskin quarterback. He'll be facing this Ram defensive unit. Three-man front, Reed Miller in the middle, and Reggie Doss. Owens, Giroux, Eckern, and Mike Wilcher, the linebackers. And in the secondary, Jerry Gray and Leroy Irvin on the corners. And the two safety men, Nolan Cromwell and Vince Newsom. Here's Schrader coming over for a last-minute check with the sideline. Led the NFC in passing yardage. 22 touchdowns and an equal number of interceptions. Most of them late in the year. Clark comes wide to the left. Monk wide right. Didier on the move, and now Warren behind him. George Rogers looked as if he had early room, and then it closed up in a hurry. Led by Mark Giroux. A gain of two. The offensive group for the Redskins. Schrader the quarterback. Rogers the lone setback usually. Monk and Clark wide, and then they do different things with Warren and Didier. Up front, Jacoby and Grimm. Bostic, R.C. Thielman, and Mark May. Second and eight. On the stop.
Yeah, as we see, Donnie Warren only caught 20 balls all season, and he's used mostly as a blocker, as we said earlier. But I think the more zone that you play against the Redskins, and I think Jay Schrader's the type of guy who's going to get a lot of zone, the more you have to get your tight end involved. So I think we're going to see Donnie Warren and Clint Didier get more passes today.
Third and short. Out of sync. Rogers got enough, but flags flew early. Doug Reed made the stop. Going to be against the Redskins.
For being out of sync. You said they were out of sync, and the official, boom, they threw the flag and said out of sync.
There we go, motion. Number 63, offense. 5-yard penalty, repeat, third down.
That's Raleigh McKenzie, number 63. See him? He comes in as tight end. He's a backup guard, but he comes in and plays tight end on short yardage. And you see, he's not used to being out there on that end.
That makes it third and six.
He's not used to being in there. He jumps offside.
Part of the heavy jumbo package. Kelvin Bryant has replaced Rogers. That's Monk. Moving. Schrader back to throw. Has some time for Didier. Ball bounding around. Covered by Leroy Irvin. Knocked down, but a flag down.
And that flag came out there late, too, Pat. I don't know about this one. This one was after the ball went down.
Or at least after the ball is deflected.
I don't think that can be pass interference on Leroy Irvin. That was good defense. He was out there man-to-man on Clint Didier.
If that's what the call is, after that ball is deflected, that belongs to anyone.
Well, see, I think the field judge is coming in there and telling Nelson the back Coons, judge.
Number 47 on the defense. Automatic first down.
I don't think that's right. I thought that was good defense. I thought that Irvin and the ball arrived about the same time. Watch it. It's right here. That's Didier, the receiver. Irvin starts to go back, comes up. He has to be able to go for the ball. I don't see any interference on that.
There might be a review. I think another penalty marker has been thrown. Leroy Irvin obviously really upset.
Well, you know, I know.
It's my conduct. Number 47 on the defense. Still first down.
I know what he's upset about. I mean, he's out there. He's playing against a 6'5", 240-pound guy. The ball's in the air. He has to be able to do something. Watch it again. Here it comes to Didier. He's coming up. He has a right to go for the ball. He sticks his left arm around him. He knocks the ball out of there. I don't know what the guy has to do. I mean, you can't let him do nothing back there. Just let him catch the ball.
Got to play defense, don't you? Schrader going right to work out to him. Hit hard early and quickly by Jerry Gray, but he still got 7 yards. That's one he'll think about for a while.
That's what he's telling him. Art Monk is not a talkative guy anyway. Jerry Gray said something to him, and Art Monk said something right back to him. There could be some guys in the league that can be intimidated. Art Monk is not one of them.
Never has been.
Never will be.
Second down and 3. Redskins on the move at the Ram. 22-yard line. Make it the 21. Rodgers over the left side. First down. Gain of 4. Redskins leading 3-0. Reggie Doss made the stop.
You know, over the years, the Redskins have made a lot of mileage over that left side. Right in there behind Russ Grimm and Joe Jacoby. You can talk about all-pro linemen, but I think when you get Bostic to center and Grimm and Jacoby healthy, there is too good of offensive linemen as there are in this league.
And over the years, as you say, they have been. Those two side-by-side are a full truckload. About the 13, Sean Miller tripped him up.
I know, you know, we look at both sidelines here, and I think both of them went in with that same type of game plan to get control of the game
early.
Control the ball early, run it, let your offensive line dominate their defensive line. Thus far, the Redskins have done it.
Neither one of them, John, feel that they have great come-from-behind teams.
Some tough breaks. They had a turnover, and they've had 30 yards of penalties on this drive.
That's Rodgers dodging, gets back to about the line of scrimmage, and that's about it before Vince Newsom knocked him down.
And we'll see the left side over there. They're trying to get in there. See, they have the scoop block. Grimm gets his guy. They don't get the linebacker, and Newsom, who's the safety, was up in the backfield. That's always tough because you don't account for those safeties.
Third down and 7. Elvin Bryant. Line up deep. Schrader back to throw. Kelvin Bryant out of the backfield. Touchdown Redskins. He got it.
George Rogers doing the running work, Kelvin Bryant coming in for Rogers and doing the passing work out of the backfield.
Atkinson for the extra point. Schrader holding to make it 10-0. And does. Here's the touchdown.
For the guy in the end zone, and he finds him.
Madden. We're at RFK Stadium, the wild card game between the Rams and the Redskins. And Jay Schrader just hit Kelvin Bryant with a 14-yard touchdown pass. The Redskins lead it 10-0. Mickey Sutton and Charles White back deep to Steve Cox. Kicks it off, a knuckler. Trying to find a handle is Sutton, and he finally does, and finally comes out of the pack. He's hit by Darryl Green, and finally, with some help from some more Redskins, he's down at the 25.
Let's watch the touchdown again. Here's Kelvin Bryant. He's just going to run right through the zone here and catch a touchdown pass here. But watch the move that he makes. He makes the old street head fake right here. Watch him right there. See, he turns and looks out. That brings him up, takes him really taking a bite, and now he runs right through him. Watch him. You see, they take the bite on that head fake. He runs right through him, splits the entire zone.
At the 25, the Rams give it to Dickerson. Gets a couple of tough yards. Calvin Daniels, there's the man who scored the touchdown.
Tell you, you know, last week he got hit against the Eagles, and they found on Monday he had blood in his urine, so they hospitalized him, checked his ribs and kidneys, and then they didn't know early in the week if he'd even be able to play this week. But he came out, practiced later in the week, talked to him yesterday and said he's fine. Everything cleared up.
Henry Ellard is split wide to the right. Kevin House to the left. Everett back to throw. Oh, he's got a man. Look out. Kevin House had about four steps on the nearest defender, who was Curtis Jordan. And he finally got him down. If he had been able to stay on his feet, the Rams would have been on the scoreboard.
Redskins are in a zone. You see, Tim Morrison was looking into the backfield. Kevin House just ran right by Morrison. Then the safety, Curtis Jordan, didn't get over there. I'll tell you, Everett just got that ball off.
That's Darryl Grant that hit him. He never saw that completion. 45-yard gain, they say now. Ram first down inside the Redskin 30. Dickerson deep. Redden gets the carry, and Redden gets only a couple. Darryl Grant tripped him up.
You know what the Redskins are doing? They're putting Darryl Green, who's their all-pro corner, number 28 there, they're putting him man-to-man on Henry Ellard, figuring that Ellard is the best of the Rams receivers. And then they're letting Tim Morrison, who's a rookie, cover Kevin House. So I wouldn't be surprised if the Rams go to House more today than they go to Ellard.
Well, the house got open. This probably, unless it's a quick incompletion, is the last play of the first quarter. Now it's Redden in motion, and that's Dickerson hammering into the Redskins secondary down to the 20. A gain of 7. And that'll be the end of the first quarter. Dominated by turnovers in the Redskins as they lead it 10-0 at RFK. CBS. The 1986 playoffs. We're at the wild card game at RFK Stadium between the Rams and the Redskins. And at the end of the first quarter, Washington 10, the Rams nothing. Washington had 5 first downs in the first quarter. The Rams had 4. But penalties and turnovers, quick ones, helped the Redskins get to the scoreboard. A touchdown pass from Schrader to Kelvin Bryant, and a field goal by Atkinson is how they molded the lead. Third down. Redden and Dickerson in the backfield. Redden coming out. Hand off Dickerson, and he gets the first down. Hurls himself down to about the 17. Todd Bowles again on a stop along with Charles Mann.
You know, the interesting thing about that play is how Dickerson can start, and he's just running to the left. He starts to the left, and then he's just going to cut and go any place he can. Watch him here. He starts here out. Boom. He sees something, hits it back to the inside, wherever he finds a soft spot.
And he can find him. On first down, Dickerson again, looking for the soft spot. Ball came loose. Flag is down. Fumble. Flags. Redskins have the ball, but Cole with a second. There's a penalty marker down.
Holding, number 81, offense. Coming to the line, first down the other way.
On David Hill. Tim Morrison came up with the football for the Redskins, and the Rams are stymied again. Redskins take over. Rams on the move, and a dismayed John Robinson. It's one thing he feared most.
National Football League is sponsored by the Heartbeat of America, today's Chevrolet. Stroh's and Stroh Light, now you're talking good times, and Stroh's is spoken here. And by the Travelers, one of America's strongest, most experienced financial experts.
Watch the last play here. Right here is the hole. We see David Hill with a hole there. So that's a penalty they call. Now let's see the fumble again. Neil Okowicz, number 52, is going to come in and hit Dickerson and knock the ball out. There he is right there. See him hit it with his right hand. Right there. That knocks the ball out, and the Redskins come up with the fumble. That's Dickerson's second fumble today. He had 15 during the regular season and lost 11 of them.
That would be about the only negative for that man, Eric Dickerson. Two today.
Yeah, they were headed in. Held him back today. Is that two? And then, of course, they had 30 yards of fumble on that one Redskin touchdown drive.
Here's Rodgers. Right up the middle. Got a couple. Doug Reed stopped him. It'll bring up a second down and about eight. Selection of plays so far. The Rams running as they wanted to. 12 against four passes. The Redskins as they wanted to with balance. Second and eight. Didier split wide left. The handoff is to Rodgers. And Rodgers outside the 15, about the 17. He'll still need a little bit more to move the sticks in a first down. Ram offensive unit, Dennis Harris sitting up on top of the bench, and Jackie Slater to his left. Third and two. I don't think any defense that the Redskins play could be too much of a surprise to that offensive unit. Third down and two. To the right, Monk was in motion. Schrader with time, up the middle, ball in the air, batted around, deflected, and the Redskins will have to punt. Art Monk was the intended receiver. Knocked around into the air by Carl Eckern and Mark Giroux.
Eckern almost made a heck of an interception. He had a couple bounces there, then he was falling to the ground, almost came up with that thing.
Here's the almost.
He's going down. He gets a tip with the right hand, tips it up over, and he tipped it right out of reach.
Steve Cox back deep. The Redskins and Henry Ellard, dangerous punt returner for the Rams. Line drive kick. He should have some room to operate. Jeff Bostic, who does the snapping. A 50-yard punt by Cox. A return of eight. The Rams take over. Home of the Redskins, RFK Stadium in Washington. And the Redskins lead at home, where they're oh so very tough. 10-0. So far, that pretty much tells you the story of the game. Eric Dickerson has fumbled twice, and the Redskins have recovered both. Schrader, 14-yard touchdown pass to Kelvin Bryant. And Atkinson, a 25-yard field goal. It's 10-0. Penalties have been a factor already. Most of them against the Rams. The give is to Eric Dickerson, right side. He got two. Alvin Walton, young safety man who has acquired a reputation as being quite a hitter. in this Redskin defense.
You know, one of the things Joe Gibbs was talking about is defense. He said, we just can't get any fumbles anymore. We aren't recovering fumbles. So far, they have two in this first half. The Redskins are the only team in the playoffs that had a minus in the turnover ratio.
Usually that makes quite a difference. Here's Everett. Up the middle, tight end David Hill. Into Redskin territory. Walton again on the stop, but that's a Ram first down.
Hey, Jim Everett hung in there because he's going to get pressure. Watch Dexter Manley takes an inside move on Irv Pankey. And he's right at his feet. He was, at his knees, and Mann was high. You see him, he got the old 1-2. Manley blow, and Charles Mann up on top.
Everett. Nothing but praises about his future. Nothing but bright hopes as a human being and as a player. Dickerson slipped as he came out of the emblem in the middle of the field, and Everett just got the ball to him. He lost three. Olkowitz led the defense.
I think this was a counter play. Watch Dickerson. I think he's going to step to the left, see, and then come back to the right. But as he started to go to the right, he slipped right in that emblem thing, as you say, could never get going, and the Redskins had four jerseys right there on top of him.
Second down and 13. Here comes the blitz in a hurry. David Hill again. Walton. David has not been very much a member of the Ram receiving core, but the last two have been clutch ones.
Well, you know, they even take David Hill out and they put in Darren Long when they go to the passing game. Hill is really the blocker. And of course, you know, that's the thing that they're looking out for, I think, and then boom, they sneak him in the middle and then across on that one, get two plays to Hill.
Third and one. A gain of 12. Hill's second reception. Johnson was the man in motion, but Dickerson is the man with the football and the Ram first down. Pickup of four. Curtis Jordan finally tripped him up.
Well, that's where they go in there. You talk about those Pro Bowl linemen, Dennis Hare, the right guard, Jackie Slater, the right tackle, and then David Hill. You take that ball on short yardage, and if you have three all-pro guys, just get right in behind them. It's what they're all-pro for. They help you get first down.
Rams were one man short, and Tim Tyrell just hustled into the lineup. And now, because of that short number of people, they take a timeout. That's their first. That'll mean they have two left in the first half. 10:03 left in the first half with the Redskins leading 10-0. Till this one is over, John, we don't know who'll be where, but we'll be in New York. And I don't know, going in, what team do you think?
Well, I always like the intensity of the playoffs. I mean, I think there are some lookout teams. Teams you better look out for. I think, obviously, the Giants are one. I don't think you can count those Bears out because
no,
the defense
indeed
is too good. Then the lookout team, I think, is a team out in San Francisco, the 49ers. I think at the end of the season, they could be playing the best of anyone in the NFC.
In terms of balance, I think, as you said, the Bears' defense, the Giants' defense. But look out for the 49ers. Look out for the Rams. Look out for David Hill. He's a factor. Ball is on the ground. And it looks like it must be a fumble. Nobody has indicated otherwise. Neil Okolich came up with it. David Hill is still back here. And now the official back at the spot where Hill went down says he was down. And they're going to bring it all back, I think.
Here to see if he went down. There's a knee down right there. He had possession. Now after that, he loses possession. So what he said is right. He had possession when the knee went down.
Still a Rams ball. Second and eight.
I think they're going to look at that on instant replay, though, Pat. They just stopped the play, so they're talking to the referee. Well, they're talking to the umpire, who talks to the referee.
And Dexter Manley is up saying, hey, it should be ours.
I think the key here is when the knee goes down. When the knee's down, he's going to blow the whistle. The knee's down now. Who has the ball?
He does.
He does. And it's okay.
The play is being reviewed.
Gordon McCarter, the referee. Play is still being reviewed. Joe Gardy is the NFL official in charge at whom you just looked.
The official there is Al Jury. He's a highway patrolman in California. He gets it during the week, and he comes out and gets you in the weekends.
Approximately, total plays 35,000. That's mind-boggling. The reversals, not many. 38, another indicative statistic of what an outstanding job the officials do, and they're still reviewing. Gordon McCarter on the right of your picture. And the conference moves further away from the players.
You know, this the one thing about instant replay, it's very vulnerable. And it's easy for someone to say that it takes too long and they shouldn't do it. There's Jack Kent Cook, of course, the owner of the Redskins, and he's not thinking it's taking too long. He just wants it to be the Redskins' ball.
Dexter Manley's
trying to get the crowd going. He's trying to get the crowd to help that guy up in the booth. That's Jack Fetty, the official there. Now, in the playoffs, they have all-star officiating crews. This crew doesn't work together. They're picked for the playoffs based on their grades during the regular season. So it's not a crew. It's the top referees, top umpires, field judges, and so on.
That doesn't mean that they can't work again down the road somewhere in the playoffs. And they're still reviewing.
Let's see it. You know, again, the knee's down. Now, I don't know. They make look, does he have possession?
It could be ruled if they decide he didn't have possession. It could be just an incomplete pass, and they're still talking about it. That's Joe Cardi on the left.
I don't know if it changes. But I'll tell you, I mean, as I was saying earlier, it is a vulnerable thing, and it's easy to criticize, and this situation is very easy for everyone to say they ought to do away with it. I think that's the answer. I think you have to stay with it, keep it. It's going to help football.
And the review continues. 9:41 left to play in the first half. Redskins 10, Rams nothing.
You know, that could be the other thing. Is it a complete pass or
right.
An incomplete pass? Is it a fumble or not a fumble?
Was his knee down?
His knee was down, but did he have control of the ball or not?
John Robinson with a little bit of disgust in his mind. And Joe Gibbs looking on and conversing with people up in the press box. The Redskins are saying and starting a chant now of, hey, it's our ball. Redskins, Redskins. And they still continue to review.
Well, see, number 106 there, the back judge, he's the guy that made the call. So he's the guy that they have to talk into and see what he says.
Instant replay is reviewed and determined that the ball was fumbled, recovered by the Redskins. It was reviewed at the 45-yard
line. First down. It helps to play at home.
Look at that one. You can say that his knee hit and the ball wasn't fumbled yet, but there was no control of it.
Third turnover by the Rams. Third fumble by the Rams. And the Redskins have it at their own 45. They lead 10-0 already. Now the offensive unit, Redskins on the field, and the Rams defense ready to go. Didier wide left. Rodgers pinned into the backfield, had to do a dance, and is taken down almost at the line of scrimmage by Greg Meisner.
What the ruling was, Pat, is they thought the ball was loose before his knee hit the ground. It hadn't been fumbled to the ground, but they thought it was loose before the knee hit the ground.
Second down and 10. Redskins, their own 45. They lead 10-0. Just over 9 minutes left in the first half. Monk was the man in motion. Outside quickly, Rodgers. They set that up nicely. The lineman got out in front, but so did the Ram defense after a gain of four. Meisner was the first man there.
You know, they're going to have to, they're going to have to think when they have these long instant replays, as we watch the replay of the screen, of letting these guys have another warm-up. After they stand out there and they wait, they all get a little cold and tight. They have to kind of start the game over again.
Rodgers leaves. Of course, normally he would leave in this situation anyway. Takes his place. Third and six.
You know, the advantage of having a guy like Kelvin Bryant in there is usually your best cover guys are on the corners, the next best on the third end, and he's playing against the fourth or fifth best cover guy.
Out of the backfield he comes. Now they go to Clark. And that's enough for the first down. Johnny Johnson was the first Ram.
Clark is something. He was injured a couple weeks ago, an ankle injury against Denver. Really hadn't played nor practiced since then. We were out here watching him in practice yesterday. He didn't do anything, just stood around all day. And then on Sunday, game day, playoff time, he gets it up to play.
His first NFL playoff game. He wound up second in the NFC. Rodgers back in the game behind Schrader. Close to being a 17-0 or at least 16-0 Redskin lead. Leroy Irvin back with Didier, who's playing with an injured hand, in all fairness.
And there's Vince Newsom, the safety. Didier gets behind both of them. I'll tell you, don't tell Jay Schrader you can't throw deep against his zone. Jay Schrader has his own mind. A lot of quarterbacks look short and then go deeper, look short, medium, and deep. Jay Schrader looks deep, wants to throw deep, and then comes back.
Get it upfield. He believes in that. Kelvin Bryant to Schrader's left. That's Didier again in motion. Schrader to Bryant. 3-yard gain.
See, now you see the quarterback giving the signals. He's telling the bench the down and distance, or the distance to go. And then sometimes a quarterback can signal to the bench what he wants. So he signals six, whatever that meant. Hey, pretty good protection. You see, they have that good protection. Give him a good pocket. Oh, Russ Grimm going against Gary Jeter. He just keeps going. The ball's been thrown. Oh, Grimm's still blocking.
Jeter thought he'd been held. This time, Schrader gets it downfield to Sanders. That's enough for another Redskin first down, a gain of 10. Jerry Gray on the coverage.
There's a big play guy. You know, Sanders is one of those guys, rookie USFL guy, who makes big plays. Joe Gibbs says last week against the Eagles, Sanders made one of the best catches he's ever seen in his life. He said he just has a feeling downfield in that open field of being able to adjust and get to any ball.
And very soft hands. He says you never hear the ball when he catches it.
Well, calls him a big yardage guy.
First down, Redskins. The Rams 29. Rodgers to the 20 or 21. Andrew tripped him up, but Rodgers got 8.
You know, the Redskins are playing the type of game that both teams wanted to play. Watch the left side of the line there. Watch Grimm, 68. Jacoby, 66. Watch the movement. Grimm fires out. Jacoby gets his guy going back, 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 back. Grimm is out there, and that's a big hole for Rodgers. I tell you, did you see Joe Jacoby?
Yes.
And Reggie Doss?
Yes.
Whew. That's what you call taking backwards. Him for a ride.
Second down. They need two for a first.
$6,000 for this game. The right guard of the Redskins, R.C. Thielman, he wants to buy a tractor with his money. Everyone was excited about getting into playoffs. Thielman was excited because he said he can buy a John Deere tractor now.
Washington in this drive. Falls for a gain of 2.
Greg Meisner got penetration there. I don't think Jeff Bostic got Meisner, number 69. And if you're going to run the ball, you have to get some movement on that nose tackle. You can't let him get any penetration. Watch your nose tackle right over the center. You see, he gets penetration. It's a double team. He just split that thing and got in there enough to knock the ball carry off.
Second and 8, Kelvin Bryant replaces Rodgers. Bryant gets the carry. Inside the 5 to about the 3 is Bryant. Maybe the 2. Wilshire finally got him down. First down, Redskins, a gain of 9 by Bryant.
I tell you, talking about the nose tackle, what's the job that they do on the nose tackle this time? If he gets here, you can't, but if you get him going back here, you can run. Now watch the fire out there. Bostic starts out. Thielman helps him. They get him going backwards. See, then they get him turned, and that's the hole that Kelvin Bryant could get in. If you get that guy going backwards, you're always going to have a big soft spot in there.
And that runner is going to have a place to go. Rodgers is back behind Warren. Scrimmage. That's all. Sean Miller was the first Ram on the scene.
You know, it's a funny thing. We talk about the nose tackle. You get two plays. He makes a play. They don't make anything. Then the play that they get him going backwards is when they make the run.
Second and goal from just outside the 4. 10-0 Redskins leading the Rams. Rodgers looking ahead and hoping he's going to get it. And he's to about the 1.5-yard line, tripped up by Wilshire.
They have the big thing. They have Donnie Warren, who's right in front of Rodgers. He's looking. He knows he's going to get the ball, reading the whole thing, getting right in behind Warren, then seeing there's nothing there, then cutting back against the grain. When they used to have John Riggins, you always knew two things. One, Riggins was going to get the ball here. Two, on the left side.
2 minutes remaining in the first half, and the Redskins leading 10-0. Guard game at RFK Stadium. The Redskins leading the Rams 10-0. 2 minutes left, first half. Pat Summerall and John Madden. It's third down and goal. The ball's at the 2. The Redskins have taken out Jumbo Heavy, or Heavy Jumbo, and put back in the receivers, Clark and Monk. So it looks like they might put it up.
Well, I would think that it would be some kind of play pass, or maybe that's just what the Redskins want the Rams to think, and they're going to run. But they did go from a running formation to a passing formation. And it sure looks like pass to me.
Clark and Monk both split wide to the left. Kelvin Bryant behind Schrader. Sprint out left. Schrader's got some room himself, but he doesn't get in. Leroy Irvin stopped him, no gain. Not what they had in mind, and now they'll have to settle field goal.
Well, I think it was one of those option things that they were looking for, where he's going to roll out. He's going to roll out here, and he's looking. He doesn't have anyone. He doesn't have Monk in there right then. He had to decide to run. He had the blockers in front of him, but Leroy Irvin got through that line of blockers and made the tackle.
Atkinson on the scene. Out on the field. This will be about 21 yards away for this field goal attempt with Schrader holding. He has made one. He's been successful from 25 yards out. Down as long as they can, and they let it run out, and now they'll back him up a little bit, and now a timeout Redskins. They used as much of the clock as they could and then took the timeout. They lead 10-0, the Redskins do. 108 left in the first half. 10-0 Redskins over the Rams. Redskins win. Go to play the Bears. Darkness gathering, the Capitol, that magnificent sight, the Washington Monument in the background. Renovations, of course, going on the Capitol building of this country. Schrader now right at the 10-yard line, and so it'll be a 20-yard field goal attempt by Jess Atkinson. Yes, I'm ready. And yes, it's good. And it's 13-0 with a minute, 5 seconds left to play in the first half. The Redskins over the Rams. They've been able to move and take advantage of turnover.
Stadium and the Washington Redskins are ahead of the Los Angeles Rams, 13-0. And I'm in the Redskins owner's box, Mr. Jack Kent Cook. Mr. Cook, there was a long delay in the second quarter on an instant replay ruling. What did you see?
I saw a fumble, and I was so pleased to see that our instant replay eye in the sky saw what I saw. The only thing I couldn't understand, Irv, why it took them so long to arrive at that conclusion. It was so obvious to me. Wasn't it to you?
There's
yes
a question
no?
in my mind.
That's right.
Would you vote in favor of instant replay?
Oh, I vote in favor of it. I think even had that gone against us, it would have been an absolute terrible error.
Okay.
But had it gone against us...
All right. Thanks very much, Mr. Cook. Let's get back to the game, okay? Pat?
Flag down, as you can see on the other side of that pileup, a return of 17 yards by Mickey Sutton. And it looks like it could be against the Rams, and they have had nothing but misfortune in the first half. The Redskins lead it 13-0.
Well, you know, the Rams have had misfortune, but I think that the Redskin defense is playing the type of defense that is causing that.
Illegal block, number 32, receiving team during the return. Off the distance penalty, first down.
You know, they're hustling all over the field. They're tackling the ball. They're just kind of smothering that entire Ram offense.
They're doing what Joe Gibbs said to us Friday and again yesterday that they hope to do. Draw play to Redden. Redden out of the pack. Barry Redden out of bounds after a Ram first down, knocked out by Curtis Jordan. He got 13 yards.
I'll tell you, Barry Redden almost knocked out Darryl Green. Green was a corner here, had to come up and support. I'll tell you, he came up like he was going to make the tackle. Watch, it'll be right here in the bottom of the screen. Watch 28. He comes, I got him, I got him, I got him. I'm going to square in on him, zero up on him. Wham! He just ran right through that tackle.
Not much web.
Well, it was a little rough. It didn't work. That Breton's a strong guy.
52 seconds still remain. Manley on the rush. They give the screen pass to Dickerson. He got a little room and gets another Ram first down. In the meantime, there's a penalty marker down, and so is Dexter Manley down. A gain of 13. Against the Rams, it's going to be holding.
Manley went after jump up and started to go into fight. That was Duval Love. Manley went down. Then he like he was out. Then he came out of it, jumped up, and went after Love.
A delayed man.
Duval Love says, what'd he do?
Holding number 67 on the offense. Pass the distance penalty, repeat the down.
Duval Love.
Watch, Duval Love is there, number 67. He's blocking Manley. Now he's going to get caught right there for a hold and a takedown. You see, he gets the knee. That's the thing that made Manley mad. See, now Manley's down. He's like he's out. See, he gets him here. He doesn't mind being hold. That makes him mad, but getting the knee really makes him mad. He gets the flag. He's down. He's out for a while. Then he jumps up and goes after Love. I don't know why Duval Love is in there.
I don't either. I was about to ask you that. First and 20. Kirk Pankey is over on the sideline. Here's Dickerson. They said he hadn't broken a long one. He almost broke a very long one. First down, Pankey. The word is that the reason Duval Love is playing is that Pankey has a cramp in his left leg. Rams take a timeout. They have only one remaining. It's 13-0 Redskins. Away from it. Fires downfield for Ellard. Incomplete. Coming up at the half, Brent Musburger and the head coach of the New York Giants, Bill Parcells, with highlights of the Kansas City-New York Jet game. They'll also be talking to the winning coach, Joe Walton, of the Jets. Irv and Will will have a live report from here at RFK Stadium. That's all coming up at the half.
Of course, Dexter Manley's in hot water with this team. He missed practice the other day and didn't know yesterday whether he was going to play or not, or suspended him. They fined him $1,000. Didn't practice on Friday, came back and practiced yesterday. Told everyone he was sorry.
25 seconds remaining.
78 offense.
Jackie Slater, the right offensive tackle for the Rams, jumped early. And he'll walk off another one against Los Angeles. 7 times they've been penalized for 73 yards. That's hard to overcome.
You know, the Rams they're not a good enough team yet that they can overcome those types of things. Penalties and turnovers.
Second down, Everett back to throw. Almost picked off. Barry Wilburn is number 45. Kevin House was the intended receiver. Clock stopped now with 19 seconds remaining first half.
You know, it has to be a good battle. We talked about earlier is Henry Ellard, who's a leading receiver of the Rams, going against Darrell Green. I don't think that Ellard has caught a pass yet. I don't think they've thrown one to him. So I have to say that Darrell Green is kind of putting a blanket on him. That's the funny thing. He was the leading receiver on the Rams team and didn't catch his first pass till the 10th game.
Well, he held out all that time. Here's Dickerson cut down in the backfield. Tom Beasley. Just brought back, just activated. Clock stops with 10 seconds remaining. And the Rams send in the punting unit.
Well, the Redskins took a timeout. They want to get one shot at it. Remember the rule here. They can go for a block. They can also fair catch it. Then if they fair catch it, they can get a free kick. Now, they got a guy, Cox, that can kick the ball. Joe Gibbs was saying he's been kicking him 60, 62 yards in practice constantly. Of course, unless it's a real short kick, I don't think they'd have a chance to do that.
With only 10 seconds remaining, it wouldn't seem that they would. 13-0, Redskins leading the Rams. Next Saturday here on CBS, the playoffs continue. And, of course, Soldier Field, the Redskins or the 49ers at Chicago, Saturday at 3:30 Eastern Time. Sunday, Coach Madden and I will move up to that location, Giant Stadium. And either the Rams or the 49ers will face the Giants next Sunday at noon. It starts with the NFL Today.
You know, the interesting thing, Bill Parcells is in the studio down there, or up there in New York. I wonder who he's been working against this week.
Both, I guarantee it. Redskins put the punt block team in action. That should be the last play of the first half. 1 second showing on the scoreboard clock. The punt was 32 yards. No return by Curtis Jordan, I believe it was deep. And then I have to beg your pardon. It was not Curtis Jordan. Henry Ellard was the first man down. Eric Yarber was the punt returner.
Well, we saw him practice this play that they have to run here. They're going to run that last ditch play where they put three guys on one side. They did it yesterday, putting them all out in the left,
right,
just like they're doing now, and they just threw the ball as far as he could.
And he can throw it a long way. Back goes Schrader. Going to have time. Going to throw it as far as he can. Almost touchdown. Almost worked. Art Monk. Ooh.
Hey, Schrader can throw it. Monk can usually catch it. The Rams can't let anyone get behind you in the end zone. They let two Redskins get behind them. Three Redskins behind them. That could very easily have been a touchdown.
Very easily. You are so right. That's the end of the first half with the score. The Redskins 13. The Rams nothing.
Brett Musburger along with Bill Parcells, the coach of the New York Giants. And Bill, John Madden raised the question, who has the coaching staff been working on this week, the Los Angeles Rams or the San Francisco 49ers?
Well, we've been doing a little of both, Brent. And in our practice, we've incorporated some of both teams and trying to get ready.
All right, there was a controversy, the first one of the playoffs, involving instant replay. In case you just joined us, it was this pass play by the Rams, Everett to Hill, Coleman over, knocks the ball down. Bill, what did you think? Was it a fumble?
Well, I don't know, Brent. I think that no matter what it was, it shouldn't take 5 minutes to decide. The intent of the thing was obvious, and if it's obvious, it should take less than 5 minutes.
Well, here was the replay that finally caused them to determine that it was a fumble, that the ball was stripped by Hill. Bill, let me ask you your feeling about instant replay, period. Should we be using it to change calls such as that?
Yes, I think so. I think anything that'll assist in the officiating, the coaches are for. I think it needs a little work, however.
Well, exactly, because as you could see, the fumble was ruled, and it went over to the Washington Redskins in that situation. And as a result of the three turnovers, the Redskins lead the Rams at the half 13-0. Out at RFK Stadium, Bill, Irv Cross is standing by, and he's close to the Redskins locker room. Irv?
You know, Brent, before I talk about what's going on in here, you know, I was standing right on the sideline right next to the play when the ball was fumbled. And I think what the officials saw, and what I saw and felt, and Coach Parcells will tell you this, you get a feeling for the game. The knee was down. It was like a bang-bang ball, you know, so it looked like the play was dead. Then the ball came out. But after seeing that replay from the end zone, you could actually see the ball dropping out before his knee hit the ground. So maybe the instant replay is the way to go. At least that angle showed that that call was a correct call to make on the replay judgment. But in any case, one of the things that Coach Gibbs wanted to do is increase the intensity level of his football team. For the last few weeks, he's been stressing the fact that he should take the ball away. Now, in the first half, they've taken the ball away three times from the Rams, shutting off Rams scoring opportunities and setting up opportunities for themselves. The intensity level is high. They feel good about their first half of play. As a matter of fact, as the players are coming down the tunnel, they said, hey, keep it up, keep it up, keep it up. 30 more minutes. Brent?
All right, Irv. And Bill, another coach was concerned about his ball club, and that was Joe Walton of the New York Jets. And earlier today in the AFC wildcard game, the Jets exploded, and they eliminated the Kansas City Chiefs, and they did it with a new quarterback. Pat Ryan replaced Kenny O'Brien and led the Jets to victory. Bill, you were out there. What about this quarterback draw on fourth and six?
Well, Kansas City was in a nickel defense, Brent, man-to-man, and they have no one assigned to the quarterback, and it was a heck of a call by the Jet coaching staff.
What'd you feel about Walton changing to Ryan in this particular instance?
Well, I think he was looking for something to give his team some impetus, and obviously it did.
Now, would you stick with Ryan next week against Cleveland?
Oh, I think based on what he saw today that he'll probably do that, yes.
Well, Ryan stepped in there, and a Along with that quarterback draw, he also chucked three touchdown passes. Key moment was the start of the second half. Blackledge was trying to rally the Chiefs. It was picked off by Kevin MacArthur, and he ran it in. Short time ago, I asked Joe Walton about the tremendous burden that had been lifted from the shoulders of the Jet coaching staff.
We start a new season today, and we're 1-0, so we feel good about that.
What did Pat Ryan mean to this victory for the Jets?
Well, he gave us a tremendous lift on offense. He's a quality kid. He's a guy that I trust. I think I have two good quarterbacks and two guys that can play and win, and we needed a little lift, and Pat came in and gave it to us.
Joe, what did Ken O'Brien feel like when you told him that he was going to be taken down today? What was his reaction?
Well, you know, when that happens, you're always disappointed, and I think he was, but I think he's a real team player, and he and Pat have a great relationship, and he rooted for Pat and helped all week, and he helped during the game today, and I'm proud of him for the way he's handled it.
And you'll stick with Ryan as a starter against Cleveland next week?
I'm not sure what I'm going to do yet. We'll make that decision later. I might change my mind if I said something now anyway.
All right, Joe, what about the Browns? What concerns you with that ball club?
Well, they're an excellent football team. They're probably playing the best of anybody in the AFC right now. I haven't really studied them that close yet. I'll start tomorrow morning looking at them, but I know they're playing good football.
All right, Joe, congratulations.
Fritz Sherman, the defensive coordinator of the Rams, with me. Fritzy was kind of loud in there at the halftime. Everybody in the country thinks you guys are going to die because it's 13-0. Seemed like they were more angry than anything else.
Yeah, I think it's pretty obvious, and John reminded them that most of what's happened to us, we have done ourselves. We committed the turnovers had a couple of crucial penalties in there, Will, which caused us to play football on a short field, and nobody plays very well there. We just need to go out and not help them, and I think we're confident we go out there and play a great second half, and we have a great chance to win a ball game.
It looks like you're going to have to come out of your game plan. You've been very conservative both sides of the ball in the first half. Now to get back, it looks like you're going to have to blitz more, and your offense is going to have to throw more.
Well, I think there's some critical third and possession down situations, 3rd and 3-6, where we've been zoned and making a play underneath, but we may have to change up with a little man in there and knock him out. We've been pretty good at what we do, but we just can't do it on a short field, so the penalties and the turnovers and those kinds of things, we need to turn around the other way.
Of the National Football League is sponsored by Bud Light. Everything else is just a light. General Electric. At GE, we bring good things to life. And by Toyota, builder of tough, powerful, reliable trucks. Toyota.
CBS Sports bringing you the playoffs in the NFL. 1986, as we near the end of the season. And certainly nearer the end for one of these two teams, as the Redskins lead the Rams 13-0 in the NFC Wild Card game. Getting ready for the start of the third quarter. Pat Summerall and John Madden, the two big backs we talked about, and that's what they did in the first half.
Well, you know, you look at that thing, and it's about as even as you can get, except for the one thing, that last one. Dickerson has fumbled twice. Rodgers has not fumbled, and that's the difference in the first half in the score.
And the Rams lost both of those Dickerson fumbles. They lost one more. Kickoff headed in the direction of Garner. Out he comes and cut down at about the 22. Jay Schrader, who likes to go upfield, no matter what the defense.
Well, I'll tell you, you know, against this Ram defense, you can see he stayed in that short area, 8 for 9, under 10, between 10 and 20, 2 for 3, and over 20 yards, he hasn't completed a pass yet.
And that's just very much against his nature, because he likes to go upfield.
You know, and I think that this game calls for a little patience by Jay Schrader, and I think he's shown that in the first half.
Didier on the move. Schrader goes to work in a hurry. The ball bounces off Monk as he started to look upfield before he had the ball. Jerry Gray was the nearest defender.
Jerry Gray expected that. It could have bounced right into Gray's hands because it comes out of Monk's hands and goes forward. As he starts to turn, it goes right by Gray. Gray was zeroed in on Monk, not watching the ball.
2nd and 10. Jerry Gray, Pro Bowl bound. When the season started, he had no idea that he'd be in that situation. 2nd down, 10, they give to Kelvin Bryant. He gets around the corner. Out of bounds after a gain of about
6, Nolan Crumwell and Jerry Gray both there. Maybe not 6, maybe about 3.
Kelvin Bryan is one of those guys that is a great runner, but because the Redskins have used him so much as a pass receiver, you kind of forget his running ability. You know, he's not that big, strong running back, you think of. He's kind of that, kind of more skinny, angular guy.
3rd and 7, I just wondered if something might be wrong with Rodgers. Remember, we saw him in the first half with his thumb being taped. Schrader back to throw. Has time. Incomplete. Flags fly from every place.
That one has to be a couple of penalties in there, because there were 3 flags coming from 3 different directions.
Do you refuse it?
Well, I can't believe they all got the same guy on that one. Yeah, I would think that I would refuse it. Because here you are, you're down 13-0. You're
holding,
going to get
number 66 on the offense. Penalty decline, 4th down.
You're going to get good field position anyway. You want to get the ball and start making something happen offensively.
Jacoby, the culprit. That's Henry Ellard, number 80. Steve Cox back deep to punt for the Redskins. Shape as far as field position is concerned. Todd Bowles on the stop. But Eller gets him back close to midfielder. Pankey back in after that cramp that put him on the sidelines in the first half. New Year's Day here on CBS. Ohio State against Texas A&M. It starts at 1:30 Eastern Time. The Big Ten against the Southwest. Into Redskin territory for a gain of about 7. Alvin Walton and Curtis Jordan had to make the stop, the 2 safety men.
You know, here's the play that we were talking about, and it's going to be keyed on the guy in the top of the screen there. As Dickerson gets the ball here, if man number 71 starts out or goes up like he did, Dickerson is going to cut it in. So he's getting the ball and he's looking right at 71. Of course, 71 went on his back that time, didn't he?
Dickerson, as the Redskins came on a wild blitz with Curtis Jordan, went right past everybody and picked up another 8. Ooh, that could have been gone.
Well, that's the type of thing that you do. I mean, you can see that they're going to blitz. They're bringing their safeties up. Now watch, here comes Jordan up. He's going to blitz there. The center picks him off. Dickerson went to the other side.
First down, Rams. Inside the Redskin 40. That's Barry Redden going the other way, and here's Dickerson rolling and bouncing off people down to about the 33. He got 5 before Vernon Dean finally put him down.
I think Dickerson had a little meeting with himself at halftime. He said, you know, I went out there the first half, I fumbled twice. I'm the guy on this team. I'm the guy. If we're going to win, I have to do well. I have to make yardage. I can't be fumbling. I can't be doing those types of things. I'm going to come out and show why I'm a superstar.
When he carries the ball more than 29 times since he's been there, the Rams have never lost. Ever. Nothing there. House, the intended receiver. Vernon Dean with him.
I think somewhere the Rams have to do a little of that. They've only completed 1 pass to an outside receiver, and that was to Kevin House. They have yet to complete one to Henry Ellard, nor have they thrown one. There's Bruce Snyder giving the signals now. That guy that was giving the signals there is the new head coach at the University of California.
Right. But staying here as long as the playoff lasts. 3rd and 5, big down. Redskins again showing blitz to Redden. Sure. Juggling, maybe. Could be incomplete.
Yeah, they said out of bounds. The official over on that side signals out of bounds.
Everett had to get rid of that ball. He just threw it out there. He didn't have control of the ball. That was a pretty good throw by Everett, though, because he had a big rush on him.
Backpedaling like that. Here's a field goal attempt coming up. Steve Dills holding. Lansford for the field goal, 51 yards out. Not sure on a cold day like this. He can get it there. That might be there. But it's wide right. And they'll bring it back to that line of scrimmage. And so the Redskins hold off the Rams and still lead 13-0, looking out for his own Giants this year, and he's been looking out pretty well.
And I bet he's looking out for the 49ers, if I were a betting man.
Which, of course, you're not. That's Rodgers back in the game, and Rodgers into the Rams secondary, cut down after a gain of about 9.5, 10. Nolan Cromwell, that might be enough, as a matter of fact, for a Redskin first down. They're going to measure.
This one, they start with a motion, I formation again, Don Warren, the tight end, in the backfield, getting a lead block, straight up the middle, boom, with the big tailback. I tell you, that's the type of thing that you want to do. You want to take the guy, take your offensive line, get in behind him, get the movement going, wear down the defense, pick up the first down, and control the game.
12-18. Left in the third quarter, Redskins leading 13-0. And the clock running. And that's what they like to do with it right now. Monk goes wide to the left. Clark comes to the right. Doubt about whether he'd play, but Clark has been there the whole time. Didier is the move man. Now Warren moves over to the left behind him. Sign of trouble.
Well, you know, that middle is doing a good job. You know, that Jeff Bostic, Russ Grimm, R.C. Thielman. Watch the center in both guards there. You see Thielman come out on the linebacker there, get a little movement there. Rodgers is able to get in behind him and cut off that block. You know, they're running off the nose tackle in there at the bubble that the linebackers create.
Second down, same formation. Zip, Warren stays. Got six.
Hey, this Redskin team and this type of blocking reminds me of the Redskins teams that went to the Super Bowls. Watch them take off. Watch Jacoby up there, 66 on dog. Get him going back. Get him going back. Just push him off. They're just knocking him off the line on that left side over there.
Next up, Chicago. And it looks more and more like that might happen. Rodgers with 74 yards down. The Redskins hammering on the ground. Again, left side. Again, good yardage, but penalty markers come flying. Clark might have moved early.
Watch Joe Jacoby here on the end of the line. I'll circle him here so you can watch him. Watch how he gets in underneath and then roots up on Reggie Dawn. A big, tall guy, like 6'7". Watch him get underneath. You see, and then root him up. See, root him up, 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 up. Then get him turned. And then the back goes right through there.
There's the penalty.
That should never happen. That's just out there. Gary Clark, again, he hasn't been practicing with the team. And those little things, you can't do those perfectly without practicing.
Brandt has replaced Rodgers. Brandt gets a carry. Left side for two. That face belongs to Dave Butts. And that helmet has been used a few times.
And if the Redskins win, his son will be down there to carry that helmet off the field.
Boy, he's got a strong son.
Yeah, but, I mean, those are nicks in there. Those aren't just little, like, scratches.
No.
I mean, those are where you go in and you dig stuff out and throw it off.
That helmet looks like it's been through the 4th of July.
He looks like he wrestled with that thing.
And lost. Schrader back to throw. Plenty of time. As far as he can throw it, Clark over his head.
You know, you have to like Jay Schrader. Here's a guy, only in his second year as a starter. He played about a half year, started a half year last year when Joe Theismann went down, started all this year. But when you see him, he's like a kid. I mean, he has a team, like he's enjoying himself. And this, it's a game to him, and it's fun, and everyone's, you know, a friend. And you just go out there and play the game. Nothing seems to upset this guy.
To us, he is a kid.
Yeah, that's right.
Third down. They need 13. Pays the price. As the Rams, Jerry Gray and Vince Newsom are up in a hurry. Punting team on. The Redskins took some time off the clock. Which now leading 13-0 is very important to them. Pat Summerall and John Madden. Again, the Redskins take their time. Steve Cox in the punt. And back deep for the Rams, Henry Eller. High kick. Johnny Johnson signals fair catch. And he was back there with Ellard. Only a 28-yard kick by Cox. And so the Rams take over. But with a long way to go. Card playoff game. Rams-Redskins with Washington leading 13-0.
We can see that Everett has spread the ball around. He's 2-for-4 under 10. 2-for-4, 10-20. 0-for-2 into 20-30. Nothing into 30-40. And then 1-for-1, that big one that he hit Kevin House on. I think his problem is he hasn't been able, other than one time, to get the ball to a wide receiver.
The Redskins have done a lot of blitzing, a lot of different blitzing schemes. They hope to confuse him, and maybe they have. First down, Everett back to throw. And down he goes in the arms of Charles Mann, the first sack of the day.
The best start of this Redskin defensive line. Then he injured a knee and Manley came on and had a big year. But Mann, I think, is going to be the future star in this defensive line of the Redskins. Hey, he just went right by Jackie Slater.
Second and 20. Dickerson standing in the end zone, but they give it to Redden. He comes out and is really hit by Alvin Walton.
Talk about a de-cleater. When Walton hits him, those cleats go out of the ground.
Steve Bartkowski over on the Ram bench.
You know, John Robinson said last night that Bartkowski had a great week in practice. He says, if Everett struggles during this game, I won't hesitate to go to Bartkowski in the second half.
That might be soon. Third and 16 they face right now. Movement and penalty markers come down.
Tried to get a jump on him, and he moved before the ball was snapped. Those guys, you know, great defensive players not
Ball
only make
start,
plays.
Number 78 offense, still third down.
But they caused the other side to make penalty. This happens when a Charles Mann is going well. It happens when a Manley is going well. You see it a lot on a Lawrence Taylor. Guys trying to block him are always getting going before the ball snaps.
Saw it happen earlier in the year, midway, when Dallas played in New York, and George Martin did such a number. Here's Dickerson. Dickerson gets maybe to the 5, and the Rams will have to punt. Only a gain of 2. And Monty Coleman put the clamp on Eric Dickerson along with Rich Mullott.
this Redskin team right now.
Eric Yarber, number 80, goes back deep for the Redskins. Hatcher with his back to you and his back to the back of the end zone. Will punt for the Rams. At the 46 is Yarber. Yard punt by Hatcher. As we do on Saturday to both coaches and players and what have you, things rarely work out like they hope, but I think for the Redskins today, things really have.
Well, it's just what they wanted to do. They wanted to be able to get the ball, not have to force things, not have Schrader have to throw the ball, get a running game going, control it with their offensive line, and smother and tackle with their defense. Now, that's a big thing I think they've done. They've really smothered this Ram team.
They really have. They've been pretty much in control from the beginning. They took advantage of the opportunities that they got from those Ram turnovers, and they lead it 13-0. They give to Rodgers, and Rodgers cuts over the middle, got a couple. Sean Miller made the stop. The Ram bench, Jackie Slater, the offensive unit. They've had a tough time.
Well, there's Dennis Herron, number 60, and Jackie Slater. They're both the, you know, the right side of that Ram offensive line. Guys going to the Pro Bowl, but they really haven't been able to get it started today and get control of it. And I think, as I said earlier, I think the Redskins have gotten control of them.
Second and eight. Redskins have the ball, Ram 37. Ricky Sanders split wide to the right. They give again to Rodgers. Straight ahead, Mel Owens and Mark Giroux. Rodgers got five, and it was a tough, hard five by George Rodgers.
Well, it was. He finished off a run. You know, I mean, they had those hogs in there kind of rooting out. You know, you get the hogs in front, and they root, 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 and then you get George Rodgers come in there, and he finishes off the root. But watch them now. They all get going, double team in the nose tackle, kick out by Warren. Now watch how you finish out the root. You see, you just get your left shoulder down, and boom, and come right up through on a root.
Good block by Russ Grimm. Brand replaced Rodgers. Schrader, outside Sanders. Driven backwards, but he got the first down. A gain of five, Johnny Johnson, the defender, but they'll move the markers.
This really isn't Jay Schrader's type of game. But Jay Schrader is playing with discipline and patience that you have to play against a Ram defense.
Because of their zone philosophy.
That's right. I mean, you can't go for the big ones. You can't let them get you off balance. You just have to nickel and dime them.
Sanders goes wide to the left this time, and Monk is split out of your picture to the right. That's Zinnier on the move. Schrader fakes. Fires to Monk. Interesting Joe Gibbs comment yesterday when we were doing our regular ritual. And you said, what about Art Monk? And he said, Art Monk is Art Monk.
Yeah. And I think of all the guys, if Joe Gibbs has a favorite player, I think it's Art Monk. I mean, he's the type, first guy out at practice, last guy to leave, never miss a practice, never miss a game, never miss a play. You know, if there's such a thing as Mr. Dependable, that's Art Monk.
Second down. Rodgers is back. Rodgers left side to about just short of the 20. Stopped by Mike Wilcher, but a gain of three.
Uh-oh, Russ Grimm is raising his hand coming out of the game. Looks like he pulled something. Oh, now he says, I'll stay in here. A guy like Russ, he'll just rub some dirt on some of that stuff. You get some combinations up in there or something, you just kind of rub some mud on it. No one even watches those old guards. And Russ is that kind of player. I mean, he's an old-fashioned guy. You just prop him up and play him.
Third and three, and the Redskins decide, hey, wait a minute. Let's have a look at some people. And they call a timeout.
Schrader comes over to the sideline. 3:05 left in the third quarter. Brent, thank you. As Russ Grimm heads for the Redskin locker room. It appeared, I know he'd had some neck and back and nerve problems early in the year. That looked like some sort of a leg or ankle injury.
I think Russ Grimm has had entire body this year. I mean, as you said, he's had the neck and the back, and I think he's had both legs. And now we see Riley McKenzie is in there replacing him.
He'll be next to Jacoby on the left side. Third down. That's Kelvin Bryant on the move. Schrader back quickly, fires Clark, incomplete. And we'll have another look at Jess Atkinson. Johnny Johnson was the defender. That Ram defense has been on the field an awful long time today. And the fact that they've only given up 13 points, I think, is a pretty good tribute to them.
Well, they've done a good job of holding the Redskins off, but they haven't been able to get the ball back. You know, they haven't been able to take it away. They haven't been able to get that good field position. And they think the Redskins have been just wearing them down.
Atkinson this time from 28 yards, 38 yards, Megan. He's hit two. Yard. Eric Dickerson, 18 times, 82 yards. The key statistic on him today, without degrading his great talent, is those two fumbles. Are those two fumbles? Redden, outside the 20. Gain of five. Manley again. John Robinson. He said, we've got to go back and start to do again what we do best, and that's run it.
Yeah, but it's hard to do when you get down 16 to nothing and you're getting towards the end of the third quarter.
Second and five, Dickerson again. Dickerson comes. Good night. Somebody's going to have to really run. It's going to be Darryl Green from behind. Anderson down at the 15. I didn't think anybody would catch him when he came out of the pack like that.
I'll tell you, except Darryl Green. Darryl Green is the fastest guy in the NFL, and he proved it there. That was a great race. That was like watching a 100-yard dash in the Olympics or something. Watch here. Dickerson breaks through. He's out in the open. There's no one there. Watch 28 from behind. That is a great football play. I mean, Darryl Green is in the Pro Bowl, but if he weren't, just on that play alone, he should be.
And that illustrates to you why he has that mantle. The fastest guy around. Here's Dickerson inside the 15. Manley again on the bottom of the pile. Dickerson was clocked in high school 9-4 in the 100. Darryl Green is quicker than that.
Darryl Green is still trying to get the oxygen back, though. And I'll tell you, not only that play, but Darryl Green has done a heck of a job on Ellard. The number one receiver of the Rams has yet to catch a pass, and Darryl Green has been on him all day.
Second and 9. Rams go with a two tight end setup. Johnson and Hill, they give to Dickerson, looking for some room. He gets a little bit. Down to about the 11. That'll bring up a third down package. Only two. Again, Manley. Clock running now. That would be to the end of the third quarter. Down to 5 seconds. Everett walking over to the bench, and the Rams will be content to let it run out. That's the end of the third quarter with the score Washington 16. The Rams nothing, and we now pause for a word from your local station. CBS, the playoffs of 1986. This is the wild card game between the Rams and the Redskins. And the Redskins lead with a quarter to play. 16-0. It's 3rd and 7. Jim Everett looking for somebody to give it to. In the end zone. Pocket looked, searched, and finally found.
Well, watch him here. He has good pass protection. You see, he has a pretty good thing there. There's no one to throw to. He starts, he pumps once, he's still looking. Man is chasing him. He gets rid of it, finds House right on the corner of the goal line. I tell you, hey, that was some play for House to catch that ball, stay there, and come down with both feet in bounds.
Get it in bounds. A very, very important extra point right here. And it's good at 16-7. Just barely in bounds the touchdown. Look at this.
This was one of the big things that was a plus for the Rams this year is getting Kevin House. Remember when he was just waived by Tampa Bay. The Rams were looking for a receiver, and they come up with this guy.
Especially with the loss of Ron Brown. Back to the run that set it up.
Of course, this is a big play. Now watch Dickerson. He's going to start in here, and he's going to break through. Here's Dickerson. He's going to start through here, and he's going to break it up in the middle. And we'll watch this run. Good block. Starts to the left. Now he's going to cut back to the right. Now, if we stop it right here, we'll see here's Darryl Green. Here's Dickerson. They're even. And the race starts here. And watch Green catch him. That is some sprint. And tackle.
That's closing some ground on a guy you know can really run. Eric Dickerson. Laverne Torgerson over in the middle of that Redskin meeting. And over on the other sideline. Hey, we're not out of this thing yet. 16-7. 14:51 left to play. Fourth quarter, in game. Garner back deep. Accepts the kick at the 8. Here comes a fake reverse. Flags go down. Return of 17. Vince Newsom made the stop. Let's check out with Irv Cross. Irv, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here, Pat. I'm here with Senator Eugene McCarthy from Minnesota. Is being considered as the director of the National Library of Congress. Are you concerned, Senator, today that perhaps more people in Washington are probably watching this football game than reading?
Well, not really. But I think that the library thing is a proposition to some people who want to get me out of politics. I'm a little skeptical of reading. Minnesota has the highest literacy rate of any state now. They've begun to vote Republican. So,
you know, Senator, last weekend in New York, one of our colleagues interviewed former President Richard Nixon. Any reaction?
Oh, I know you're getting down pretty low on the political totem pole. I think we're going from Nixon to me.
Senator, thanks for being with us. Let's go back to the game. Pat?
Thank you, Herb. 14:39 remaining. Off to the right side is Rogers, and Rogers out of bounds after a gain of 8 or 9, 8, call it. Johnny Johnson chased him out. Big Joe Jacoby over on the sideline.
Well, you know, that's something. That's the left side of that Redskin line. They lost Grimm. He's out now. Now Jacoby is out. He has a broken hand, and they say that he wouldn't return unless an emergency.
Grimm, we understand. I see him just walking out of the dugout right now, but he has a possible broken rib, and he may not be back. So let's check that left side of the Redskin offense. Two people. Rogers over the right side. For the first down.
You know, if we look here, this is George Rogers. His first five carries, 26 yards. His second five, 14. His third five, 20 yards. Now his fourth, 24 yards. So really, he had a little dip there, but he's about the same every five times he carries the ball.
22 carries, 96 yards. Rogers again. He did on the previous down get enough for the first down. Rams are saying he lost the football and that they've got it, but the officials don't necessarily agree. He got three. Mark Giroux on the stop.
John Robinson here has done a heck of a job with this
really?
Ram team. He's been here 4 years, taking the Rams to the playoffs every year. And he said, what I want to do is not get where we're just a playoff team. I want to get to be a Super Bowl team, a team he called a lookout team. You know, no one ever says, look out for the Rams in the playoffs.
We don't want to go there. Look out.
It's like, look out for the Bears, look out for the Giants, look out. No one ever says, look out for the Rams. He said, that's the level he wants to get to.
Rodgers left side this time behind those backup individuals we were just talking about. Giroux was the first man to get there. We were talking to Coach Robinson yesterday and asking him if he started, when he started the year, there's Russ Grimm, said he had a possible crack rib. Ask him if he felt at the beginning of the year that his team would again be in the playoffs. Only two other coaches, by the way, have ever done that. 4 years in a row, Chuck Knox and Paul Brown. And he said, yeah, I think if you told me I'd lose the players I lost and things would happen as they had, I'd be satisfied. Not without this victory, though. Schrader back in the pocket. Outside intended. Warren incomplete. And it'll bring up a fourth.
So you know the tough thing about the playoffs, Pat, is you start off the playoffs today, 10 teams are in it. 9 teams are going to lose their last game. And then that's the long off season. I think that's why the intensity level's so up. You know, there's a certain finality about playoffs. The winners go on, the losers have the rest of the year to think about it.
And you can feel, John, I know you'd agree, the level of intensity and competition go up. Cox, one off the side of his foot. With 12 minutes and 9 seconds remaining in the season for one of these two, the Redskins lead 16-7. The other guy, the customer, is going to go climb a building somewhere after the game is over. Eric Dickerson is the lone setback. And the handoff is to Dickerson, and there is nothing there.
Calvin Daniels was the first Redskin defender.
You know, Dickerson's the type of guy that you just keep pounding in there at him, and you hope that on one, like they did the last time, boom, and he'll break it through and get that big play for you.
Eric, number 29. Barry Redden now lines up to his right. He got a yard, and we'll make it second and nine. Everett back to throw. Has some time, and throws, almost has it picked off by Darrell Green. That ball slipped out of his hand. Kevin House, the intended receiver, and he and the Rams, Everett and the Rams, lucky that that one was not picked off.
Hey, you watch Everett now. Now, he's looking at David Hill first in the middle. He was looking for David Hill. Slater runs man by. Now he has to turn. You see, but what he did is he was stepping forward like he was throwing in the middle, but he threw out to his right. So he really didn't have the power on it, the zip on it. The thing kind of died on him. It was almost intercepted.
Third and nine. He operates out of the spread formation this time and has some time, and he's got some room to run. He should be able to get the first down, and does. To the 35, Curtis Jordan up in his face, but Everett, who's a big, good athlete, 6'5 and 212.
Watch him. He starts off here. They get a good block on man. You see, Slater gets man, who's the end man. He gets him to the inside. So when Everett goes back and there's nothing open, he has everything caved in to the inside. Watch it here. On the left side of the screen, you see when 71 takes the inside, they collapse that whole side.
Dickerson to the left. Milot, a gain of three.
I've always thought that a running back, a great running back, gets stronger as he goes. Here's Dickerson, his first five, second five, third five, look, and then the fourth. And you can see him going from 12 to 14 to 38 to 85. I've always felt that way about Eric Dickerson.
And all good running backs. Second and seven, Dickerson, the lone setback behind Everett. Redden in motion. Complete the defender. It was Henry Ellard. The defender never saw the ball coming.
That was Vernon Dean. It looked like Vernon Dean, number 32. Watch him on top of the screen. He gets turned around. He's facing that way, and look, he's still looking for the ball. Vernon Dean is yet to see it. It looks down. I mean, Henry Ellard did it. That's the first reception he's
right.
had today.
It is. Move into Redskin territory. Dickerson butts heads with Curtis Jordan. Pickup of two. Dickerson again well over that 100-yard figure. And a very durable individual. In fact, John Robinson said to us yesterday, we saw his most serious injury, which was to his toe. Inside the 45, another gain of two. Bring up a third down situation, and they'll have to put it up again. Kelvin Bryant, who, as John Madden was pointing out earlier in the ballgame, suffered some bruised or broken ribs. They weren't sure in the game against Philadelphia last week, now having his pads worked on. Dickerson on the sideline, third and six. With Everett in the spread, and again looks out of the pocket to Long. That's going to be very, very close.
I'll tell you, it depends on how they mark this one, although I'm sure with a score 16-7, the Rams are going to go for it anyway. But it looked like Long had the first down. Looked like he had possession of the ball beyond the first down marker.
Going to be fourth.
Well, I guess he didn't. Or they spotted it that way.
Who's back in the game now. John Robinson said he won't take a tough hit if it means making a two-yard gain out of a one-yard gain. But if you need the first down, he'll punish you.
And this is a big, big need here.
loose again. Dickerson, I think, spun for the first down. Redskins are saying they have it.
One official saying the ball is down. One official started to point that the Redskins had it. There's going to be a delay here.
The ball is ruled down. He did not make the first down.
He didn't make the first down.
Academic, but I still wonder about the third down play.
The play is being reviewed.
Aha.
I don't know what the review would be here. If it's a fumble, it's a Redskins ball. If it's not a fumble, it's a Redskins ball.
I thought when he whirled, he had enough for the first down. Maybe.
It looked like the ball was loose before he went down.
Now who gets the ball?
I think they ruled that the Redskins recovered the ball. See if the ball is loose before his knee touches.
It would have been Washington's first down either way.
That's what I thought. It's Washington's first down either way.
That's what they've ruled after review. And it's first down Redskins at their own 39-yard line. 8 minutes, 5 seconds left to play. Rodgers. That's Warren on the move. And the handoff, Rodgers. Not much there. One or two. But the clock continues to run. 16-7. Redskins over the Rams. Summerall, John Madden at RFK Stadium. Rodgers now over 100 yards, 25 carries. Redskins have won 30 straight games when one of their runners has gotten over 100 yards. Second and eight. Rodgers with counter trade left. Down.
You know, it's going to be an interesting thing if the Redskins win here and have to go into Chicago and play the Bears and not have Russ Grimm, who has a broken rib, who's down here in the sideline, not have Joe Jacoby, who has a broken hand, and then, of course, you look to one of the guys I think is the most valuable player in this team right here, Don Warren.
And it looks like he is suspect, and down he goes.
I think he is probably the most underrated player on this Redskin team.
He can do so many things. As Joe Gibbs says, he's like the 250-pound fullback playing tight end. Redskins and the Rams, and the Redskins lead it 16-7. A wild card game. We're in the fourth quarter. Dickerson, three fumbles today. Rodgers, 103 yards rushing. And Jess Atkinson, three field goals. Donnie Warren over on the sideline, number 85, had his ankle taped, but he's out nevertheless. Third and eight, and Kelvin Bryant's in the game behind Schrader. In motion. Gray goes with it. Schrader back to throw. Up into the pocket. He's hard to sack. Taking his time, throws it away and throws it out of bounds. Bought as much as he could. Ran the clock down to 6:36 and stopped it with the incompletion. The Redskins will have to punt.
You know, I think the reason that Jay Schrader is sacked so few times is because he's so strong. You know, is you get him on a sack, you get him on a rush or a push, you get your hand on him, he doesn't go down. And he can move around a little, but he's a big, strong guy. And I think that that's why he sacks a few times.
Plus, he's very fast.
That's
probably
the thing that people don't think about. Yeah. How fast he is.
Cox gets off a good punt. Henry Ellard retreats, lets it bounce, and it dies right where it hits at just about the 14-yard line. And the Rams will take it over. A punt of 43 yards by Steve Cox. NFC Divisional Playoffs next week on Saturday. They'll be, or the game will be, I should say, at Soldier Field, Chicago. Either the Redskins or the 49ers against the Bears. And on a Sunday, it begins with the NFL Today at noon. John Madden and I will be at Giants Stadium. For the Giants, we don't know who yet. The middle, and Kevin House, as Everett really threaded the needle that time between two Redskin defenders. Rams hurry up.
Of course, they have to hurry up because there's 6:06 left, and they have to think in terms of two scores.
Michael Young replaced House. He comes wide to the right. Ellard is split wide to the left. First and 10 Rams. 16-7. Everett comes out of the pocket, throws, and the pass is picked off by Alvin Walton. Walton down the far sideline, and that should just about lock it up. Washington. Looks like the Redskins will go to Soldier Field with that interception. I'm not sure that he wasn't over the line of scrimmage when he let it go.
When he hits them, he knocks your cleats out of the ground. And of course, when guys hit, they really like to get those interceptions too.
The turnover ratio, 66 plus, 85 and 86 minus 10. A great concern to the Redskins, but today, that's done it for them. On second and five, it's Rodgers again. Reggie Doss, as the clock moves down. Timeouts remaining. The Rams have all of theirs. The Redskins have two. And they start that clock again. Carries for George Rogers. Hail to the Redskins. They'll be singing again. Timeout, Redskins. Schrader, not sure. Strolls to the sideline. They have one left, but they have the lead. 4.5 minutes remaining. It would appear that the Redskins will go to Soldier Field, and the 49ers will play the Giants. Third and one. Rodgers gets the Redskin first down.
I'll tell you one thing, Pat. I've seen George Rogers run in a lot of games for the New Orleans Saints and for the Washington Redskins, and I don't think I've ever seen him run as tough as he's running today. Of course, this isn't a good sign as we see him coming out here holding his left wrist. Because the Redskins have really been hurt today. They've already lost Jacoby. They've already lost Russ Grant. That's the left side of their offensive line. And now, if there's anything wrong, seriously wrong, with George Rogers, that's a big part of their arsenal.
And don't forget that Donnie Warren and Terry Orr, although they're back in the game now, were shaken up early. They've only got a week to get ready.
Keith Griffin, who had replaced Rogers, Mark Giroux on the stop. Washington injuries today, two of their most reliable and best. In fact, I think four of them, you could say. Or Warren, and the two at the top of the list, the left side of the offensive line. Rogers in pain over on the sideline. It'll be second and six. Keith Griffin replaced Rogers. He's the lone setback. That's Warren, who seems to be okay. On the move, this is Griffin. Right side, and he squirms down to what would be something close to a first down, about the five.
I'll tell you, I was just looking at that injury list, and you think of the Chicago Bears watching. You think of Richard Dent saying, what? Jacoby may not play. He has a broken hand. And Refrigerator saying, what? Russ Grimm may not play. Yeah, hey, those guys will start bulking up back there.
The Refrigerator's going to start bulking up?
Well, he's done a good job. I mean, he's conditioned himself to about 350 pounds.
Been working on that a long time. Third and two. Didier in motion. Griffin jumps inside the five. Looks like he's got the first down. Mel Owen stripped him up. Clock stopped now at 2:19 remaining.
Well, the word on George Rogers is that he has a bruised left shoulder and he could return.
He had a shoulder problem. Remember, he hurt it midway through the season, and there was some concern about that earlier. I thought it was his hand when he first came off.
Well, you know, it looks like, you see how he's shaking that thing, you know, trying to get the feeling. You know how you get hit up there in that bone and your whole arm goes numb? That's what it looked like happened to him. And you're just trying to shake it back and get that feeling back in there.
2 minutes remaining, and it looks like the Redskins will advance and win the wild card game. Young man in the gray coat, who looks very warm, is Dave Butts' son, who will carry that helmet off when this game is over.
You know, I saw him at practice yesterday, and he had one of those remote control cars. And Dave, after practice, went out and he's playing with his son. And his son was making a remote control car go. And when it would tip over, Big Dave would run over after the car, like 50 yards away, turn it back up. And his kid, the smart one, was running the remote control.
That helmet looks like it's been run over by a car. But he's a player. Two. It was first and goal. That'll make it second and goal. John Robinson and his Rams staff on board the sideline. Joe Gibbs. Remarkable job he's done here.
Well, you know what he said the other day? He said, you know, one of these teams will find all the answers in the game, and the other team will have their chin in the floor. And that's so right. He found the answers. And the Rams have their chin in the floor. You know, they lost to Miami, next week to the 49ers, and now in the wild card. That's an ending that lives with you for a year.
On second down, they give again to Griffin. And this time, he just barely gets back to the line of scrimmage before he's hit by Reggie Doss, Vince Newsome. The Rams take a timeout.
Here's what it looks like down there. Guys, Raleigh McKenzie, did you see it? He had to block Eckert, number 55. He drives out. He can't get him, so he just grabs for him and still misses him. That's the stuff that happens down there in the pits at the end of the game. The guys figure, what the heck? The game's over. We've won. They've lost.
But the competitive nature still remains. Charles Mann over on the sideline. It would seem that he might be injured now. They advance, they will limp into Chicago.
I think, you know, they had a lot of flu going around. When we were in the locker room yesterday, Jay Schrader came out and said, don't go in there. Boy, that place is full of the flu.
You mean nobody tried to give it to you this week?
No, well, unless Schrader, I think he was protecting us. He said, don't do it. There's a lot of flu going on in that locker room. And that could be what man is suffering right now.
This telecast is presented by authority. The National Football League is intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the Washington Redskins and the National Football League is prohibited. Kelvin Bryant now behind Schrader. Third down and goal from the five, and the give is to Bryant, and Bryant spins down close to the goal line. You've heard about it. Now let 60 minutes take you there, the Lord. The miracles take place at 60 minutes. Next, here on CBS. Timeout again, Rams. Fourth down. Atkinson back on the scene to attempt his fourth field goal. He's been successful from 25, 28, and 35.
A tough one for the Redskins. You get down there, you really have the game. It's fourth down. You have to go for it somehow. So they decided, what the heck, we have a new field goal kicker. Today is the first time he's kicked a field goal for us this year, for anyone this year. So maybe we'll get him a little more practice in the playoffs. But I'll tell you, this win is really setting up two whoppers for next week. I think, you know, this team going to the Bears, I think that'll really be something. And then I think the one in Giants with the 49ers coming into New York, that's going to be a whopper.
That's the one we do next week at Giants Stadium. Don't forget the post-game show coming up next. Interviews from the locker room. And Jimmy the Greek previews the divisional playoffs. 16-7, Redskins leading, trying to make it 19-7 from 19 yards out. Atkinson is 3-for-3 so far. Schrader holding. Bang. 4-for-4. Will kick it off following football 60 minutes, except Pacific and Mountain times, where you'll see it regulation time. Hasn't been a happy place. RFK has not for the Rams to play. A minute to go. 19-7, Redskins lead.
You know, cold weather fields haven't been a happy place for the Rams to play in playoffs. In fact, in their history, they have never won a playoff game on a cold weather town or field or place.
Atkinson took the kickoff. This is Mike McDonald returning. And the Rams will take over at their own 30, including today, just what you were talking about.
I think that the Rams are the type of team that are just good enough to get there. They aren't good enough to win anything yet. But now with Jim Everett and having a quarterback, I think they're in the right direction.
That's the kind of day it's been for the Rams. The Redskins will be going to Chicago, and the 49ers will be going to Giant Stadium. Here's Everett outside to Dickerson. Flag down. Less than a minute left to play. In the game, but nobody really protested unless it was us.
Well, you know, the thing, I think that the Redskins...
Five, number 72 on the defense. 5-yard penalty, repeat first down.
The Redskins Redskins played almost a perfect game. They did offensively and defensively what they had to do. The Rams didn't. You know, they had the mistakes. They had the turnovers. They were fighting an uphill battle all day.
Everett back to throw, and he goes, picked off by Barry Wilburn. House, the intended receiver, midfield, and down he goes, and that should slam the final door. Six turnovers by the Rams, and you just can't do that. Three fumbles, four fumbles, and two interceptions.
Well, the Redskins know that that's the type of team they are. And I think that's why Joe Gibbs got mad last week in the locker room. I think that's what he's yelling. But, you know, we're not good enough to give the ball. We have to take the ball away. We have to do those things. They did it today. On the Rams side, they're saying the same thing, but they couldn't. They gave it up.
The Redskins now will just run it out. Clock shows 39 seconds remaining, and they'll take some more time off that. Chicago at Soldier Field to face the defending champion Bears. Sunday, the 49ers go to New York to face the Giants, and that'll do it. 19-7 as the clock runs down. Eric Dickerson, one big long shot. Dave Butts and his son. Studio. Also, Jimmy DeGreek looks ahead to the divisional playoffs, and Irv Cross will be in the Redskin locker room and Will McDonough in the Ram locker room. You've been watching CBS Sports coverage of the National Football League.